I have a Patreon requested video for you right now, and this request came in from Evan Lee, and it came from a conversation the two of us were having about my recent announcement that I'm going to be running the New York City Marathon, and just the idea that over the next couple of months, there's going to be a whole lot of motivation needed in order to get me through the training and then straight through to the finish line as well. So Evan proposed something that is a combination of something called the Jar of Awesome and also a cookie jar. So rather than try to paraphrase what he was explaining, I'm going to read to you what he wrote right now. The cookie jar is a phrase coined by Navy SEAL and ultra endurance athlete David Goggins. Basically, it's a list you have in your head of all the tough shit you've overcome. The Jar of Awesome is something best-selling author and entrepreneur Tim Ferris's ex-girlfriend came up with. Basically, whenever something awesome happens, big or small, you write it down on a piece of paper and put it in a jar. I really am hoping to do that Jar of Awesome. I think it's a wonderful idea, but for this particular video right here, Evan was requesting a little bit of a combination of the two ideas, and he gave me 5 topics to hit, and I have a laundry list of things I could bring up for each of them, but I'm gonna limit it to 2 right now. So first up, Evan wanted to know about some failures that I've overcome. Gonna go back to high school for the first one, because in high school, I ran for student government every single year, nonstop, every opportunity I got, and I never got a position, ever, ever, ever. And I was super bummed, but I would say the reasons why I overcame it was because I never stopped. I'm a very persistent and driven person in general, and I'm really proud of myself for never giving up, and it wound up being a good thing because that's what my college essay was about. It was about how I never got the position, but I never gave up, and I'm never gonna give up with anything I want to achieve in life. So that turned out to be a pretty good thing. For the second one here, let's go with when I got to grad school. So in my program, a lot of the people that were in my class, they had filmmaking experience. This was when I was pursuing my film MFA. So the very first year of the program, I was on the producing track, but every single person, whether you're a writer, a director, or a producer, you have to take the same classes. One of them was directing one. And I had never really directed anything, and I was one of the only ones in that class who hadn't, and the first assignment, wow, mine was bad. And it wasn't for lack of effort. It was just plain old bad, and my professor at the time was Ramin Barani. You might have seen his work before. I greatly admire him, but he didn't go easy on me, and my initial reaction was like, oh, wow, I just suck at this. I should drop out of the program and just quit, but I didn't. And he didn't get easier on me as we went from exercise to exercise. He kept pushing me, and it hit a point where in the final thing that we had to do of that particular class, it was something called the 3 to 5. 3 to 5 minutes short. It was basically the culmination of the first semester of the program. I walked out of his class with a short film that still to this day, I am very, very proud of. So I'm very grateful for that opportunity. And it was a really tough thing to have gone through, but it wound up working out for the better. Next up on Evan's list here are proudest moments. And for this one, let's go back to high school again. In high school, I played the saxophone, and I was really excited when I got to graduate, because who isn't? So one of the things I did during the graduation ceremony was I didn't tell anyone in my family, but I had signed up to play during the ceremony with a saxophone quartet, and it was just getting up there and surprising my whole family and playing a song with that group that I had worked really hard on and practiced a lot for. And the saxophone was just something I was very proud of throughout my entire high school experience. I played the alto saxophone, baritone saxophone, jazz band, pit orchestra, you name it. That was something I was really passionate about. So to be able to celebrate that while I was celebrating my high school graduation was just really a proud memory I will never forget. Another one, going back to my film program in grad school, was when I was awarded the Richard Brick Producing Prize. The late Richard Brick was a prolific producer, and he was one of my favorite professors throughout my entire run in that program. And I'll just never forget so many of the assignments that he challenged us with, and in particular, just the visual of making a physical strip board. Now you have programs that can do all these things for you, but something about getting a hands-on experience trying to build build a schedule for a shoot was something that had always stuck with me. But he was also just very generous with his time, always helping me with assignments. And the fact that I hit a point where he wanted to honor me with this award really just, it meant the world to me. And I'll never forget that moment. Still in my parents' house to this day, I have a photo of accepting this award from him. And this was a really, really proud moment, a very special memory that I will always be greatly appreciative of. Next up on Evan's list here is things I didn't think I could do. And all right, I'm gonna go with three on this one because Evan actually said three things and I think he kind of nailed it here. So the first one he wrote was rapping for the Schmodown. You might not know this if you've seen the Collider News rap or any of that rapping, but I don't really like to make a fool of myself or get too silly ever. I get embarrassed very easily. And the day that I kind of just like sucked it up and said, you know what, I'm gonna go all in for this rap, that was really something else. And if you had asked me before I moved out to LA, would you ever do that? It would have been a hard no, but I did. And I get such a kick out of it still to this day. Still know every lyric of that Collider News rap. He also had said participating in the Schmodown, and he's right on with that as well, because I guess I would say one of my bigger fears is being wrong. Even now to this day, when I'm on Movie Talk, and if I misspeak or I say, I don't know, a wrong total for a box office performance, those are the kinds of things that sadly keep me awake at night. I'm just very hard on myself, and I was very afraid of participating in the Schmodown and being wrong. But I will say, with my limited participation, it's fun. I love that game, and that energy is just so infectious. So I will always have in the back of my brain a desire to jump back in. But the lights, you know, the pressure, it's scary. There's a lot of competition in there right now. So we'll see what happens with that. The other one Evan pointed out was producing Child Eater, producing my very first feature film. Getting through that Columbia MFA program was a huge challenge. And throughout that program, I was primarily focused on producing short films, and I found that hard. So when I jumped into my first feature, whoa, that was a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of money, but I had such good people around me. It was something that really at the very beginning of the program, I wasn't entirely confident that I was capable of doing. But when you surround yourself with the right people and you have the right story too, I really do think that could propel you through something really challenging like this. And turns out with Child Eater, it did. And yet again, it is something that I'm still very proud of to this day. Next up on Evan's list are things that inspire me. Let's get specific with this first one, just to go with something that isn't something you guys might predict. But at Sundance, I did an interview with two of the people behind the movie Cher. It's a movie that's coming out that I highly recommend. It's director Pippa Bianco and star Rianne Barreto. And during that interview, Barreto told me that they were planning to shoot the film in the United States. The problem was she couldn't get a visa. And she said that she couldn't get a visa because she was told she didn't look British enough. And she also suspects it might have something to do with her dad's background in Iraq. So I feel like in most instances, a production would have said, all right, well, we're gonna have to recast the lead role. They didn't do that though. They stood by her and they moved the entire production to Canada, still shot the movie with her in the lead role. And then the movie that they brought to Sundance was excellent. Cher, keep an eye out for it. The story is so inspiring to me. Next up, let's go with this little guy on my lap right now. So why I find Dewey so inspiring is because I grew up my entire life, never lived a day of my life actually without a family pet. But it's different when you're living at home and you have a pet because a lot of the responsibility does fall to the parents probably. But in this case, with this little guy right here, he is my very first pet that I was solely responsible for. And as much as I wanted him and I loved him, the second I got him, it's scary to be responsible for another life. So the fact that we kind of live happily ever after here in LA together, I mean, it really just is a little bit of a sign that, you know, I could take care of myself, I can adult, and I can take care of him and give him the best possible life as well. So moving on now to things that pump me up. All right, what am I going with here? I am gonna say, one thing that pumps me up on a regular basis, you've probably heard this before, is Alt Nation. When I get in the car and I'm driving somewhere important for work and I put on Alt Nation, I just get this surge of energy. I love the alt rock that they play. There's so many of my favorite bands that they play constantly, and there's something about the energy that that music gives me that truly pumps me up. Another thing that pumps me up is a good interview. So I love every single element of my career. Every single job assignment I get, I am freaking thrilled about it. But I think my favorite above all else are the interviews. And there is something about sitting across from somebody else and just connecting during one of those interviews, because I can get through almost any interview, I think. It's a different feeling when you know that you're on the same wavelength and you kind of get into that groove. So when that happens and I leave that room, I will tell you, it feels like I am floating. I love it. So that's it for this little cookie jar slash jar of awesome video. Thank you so much for the suggestion, Evan. As always, it was very inspiring. And these are things I would like to continue to think about. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you want to submit a video idea like Evan did, check that link at the bottom of the screen. That's the Patreon link, and it's got all the instructions right there. Thank you guys so much for watching this. I will see you soon with more videos.